We dug for months, years, an eternity. And we were rewarded with madness. Tragic extent of my failings. Eager to end the tiresome domestic distraction, I instructed my newly formed militia of hardened bandits, brigands, and killers to go forth and do their work. Compliance and order were restored, and the noisome population of the hamlet was culled to more manageable numbers. The smell of sulfur and gunpowder hangs in the air. The war machine is close. A fortune waiting to be spent. Is broken. Maintain the offensive. Surges as the enemy crumbles. precision and power. Onslaught. Destroy them all. Well struck. As the fiend falls, faint hope blossoms. Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies. Decimated. Great is the weapon that cuts on its own. Terrors may indeed stalk these shadows, but yonder, a glint of gold. This momentum. Push on to the task's end. Safety. Blow. slowly, gently. This is how a life is taken. Impressive. Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light? Decisive pummeling. Strike. Masterfully executed. The slow death, unforeseen, unforgiving. Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer. If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption. Size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. cursed champion falls. A hand's breadth from becoming unwound. Victories mount, so too will resistance. Beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike. Moment of respite, a chance to steel oneself against the coming horrors. In radiance, may we find victory. Nature herself, a victim to the spreading corruption, malformed with misintent. technology. An engine of destruction. Diminished. Passion is a rarity in the fevered pitch of battle. Yeah. abatement. And improvement. Blood quickens. Twisted metal and splintered wood, at home amongst the headstones. Steel and war, but nary a thought given to the plow.